Hello viewers, welcome to Studio NIOS. I am Dr. Pooja Chopra. Today we will discuss influence of community on language development of learners. Language is the road map of the culture. It tells you where its people come from and where they are going. It's a famous quote by Rita Brown. Humans are undoubtedly the most evolved species on the earth. Helping us rule this planet is not just our mental capacity, but also our ability to communicate. Imagine a day when we are not able to communicate in any way. It will be terrible and frustrating. In a way, our ability to communicate is one of the most evolved skills we have. Indeed, language is power. Language is one of the unique and advanced characteristics that man possesses, which distinguishes humans from other animals. Language is one of the unique and advanced characteristics that we possesses. Language is not only a rule-governed system of communication, but also a phenomena that to a great extent structures our thought and defines our social relationships in terms of both power and equality. In this lecture, we will first discuss the definitions of language, its importance, and then we will elaborate upon how community influences language development of learners. According to Brand Block and George Trigger, a language is a system of arbitrary vocal symbols by means of which a social group cooperate. Next definition by E. Bruce Goldstein, he defined language as a system of communication using sounds or symbols that enable us to express our feelings, thoughts, ideas, and experiences. According to him, a language is not just words. It's a culture, a tradition, a unification of a community, or a whole history that creates what a community is. It is all embodied in a language. Hence, Noam Chomsky is the one who recognizes that language evolved from a community. Community and language are not inseparable. They are linked together. Language is a tool that a community provides to its citizens. Noam Chomsky again emphasizes that language is power. To quote him again, to eliminate a nation, you don't need to use bombs. It is enough to destroy their language. Hence, we have to preserve our language. As Chomsky has rightly said, that language defines a nation. Language is the identity of a nation. How language develops? The development of oral language is one of the most natural and impressive accomplishment. Almost all children learns the rule of their language at an early age through use and over time, without formal instruction. The environment itself is also a significant factor. Children learn the specific variety of language, dialects, that the people around them speak. Linguistic diversity in India. Now, we are very lucky that we are born in India, and India is a multilingual country. India is one of the hotspots of linguistic diversity in the globe. It is high in language diversity. Around 350 languages are spoken in India. India is one of the most diversified and multilingual countries of the world, in which more than 1,000 of mother tongues were recorded by the Census of India. India has the world's second highest number of languages. after Papua New Guinea. Papua New Guinea has 839 languages, whereas India has recorded 780 languages. The speed with which normal children become linguistically proficient in not just one but often several languages by the time they are 3 years old shows that we are probably born with an innate language faculty. All specific linguistic development is, of course, socio-culturally mediated. The important thing is social and culture of the community and the society in which a child is living. And every individual successfully creates a repertoire of multiple registers to negotiate a variety of social encounters. As we all know that like learning to walk, learning to talk requires time for development and practice in everyday situations. As we have discussed earlier, that children seem born not just to speak but also to interact socially. Even before they use word, they use cries and gestures to convey meaning. They often understand the meaning that others convey. That is, before they learn to speak, they learn to understand. They learn to communicate by cues or by gestures or by babbling. These all are ways of communicating. The point of learning language and interacting socially then is not to master rules, but to make connections with other peoples and to make sense of experiences. When children develop abilities, it is always a difficult question to answer. When our child will be able to speak, it is one of the most questions that a parent asks, a young parent asks. In general, children say their first words between 12 and 18 months of age. They begin to use complex sentences by the age of 4 to 4.5 years. As with other aspects of development, language acquisition is not predictable. One child may say her first words at 10 months. Another did not utter a word till he is at 20 months. One child may use complex sentences at 5.5 years, another at 3 years. So there should not be any comparison between different children. All children learn language at their own individual capacities and their own individual rates. How community and culture influences language development? In this, to understand this theory, to concept how language and culture influences language development, we need to understand Vygotsky theory. Lev Vygotsky was a Russian psychologist. His theory suggests that although children are born with skills of language development is effective and shaped by cultural and social experiences. Vygotsky has given his socio-cultural theory of language development. According to Vygotsky, the community in which a person develops will have its own values, beliefs, and tools of intellectual adaptation. These all have an effect on cognitive functions, including language development. Vygotsky believed that language is a result of social interaction. According to Vygotsky, language is a result of social interactions and that language is responsible for the development of thought. Language is a social concept that is developed through social interaction. A child interacts first with the family and then with the immediate members of the community. Hence, community plays an active role in language development of a child. According to Vygotsky, language acquisition involves not only a child acquire words, but also an independent process of growth between thought and language. Both develop. Thought develop, as thought thinking develop, language also develops. Vygotsky's theory of language is based on constructivist learning theory, which contends that children acquire language as a result of engaging in social experiences. Through social and language interactions, older and more experienced members of a community teach younger and less experienced members the skills, values, and knowledge needed to be productive members of that community. So Vygotsky is very clear. He said that language develops as a result of interaction between an individual and his community. Language learning process occurs as a result of give and take. Parents and teachers usher a child through a process of guided discovery, addressing his or her language potential. Eventually, children internalize language skills. As young learners experience language development, they can reflect on their own thinking and their behavior and reach greater level of control and mastery over their own behavior. Hence, according to Vygotsky, language development is also related to cognitive development. Now we will discuss how school and community influences language development of children. Primary education is primarily language education, and language is not merely a component of community, but it is also the carrier of its culture. Therefore, home language assumes importance in understanding the cultural background of the learning child. In school, emphasis should be given to the use of mother tongue as a medium of instruction. The non-use of child's native language capacities resulted in alienation, non-participation, discontinuation, and large-scale dropout from the school system. There are many cases in which a very intelligent child goes into the school, but the language of the school is entirely different from its home language. Then he is not able to interact with his peers or his teachers. And due to this, he is isolated. Due to this, he is not able to achieve. And eventually, he drop out from the school system. So, language is an important part of development of child personality. Children tend to have a context-dependent style of thinking, whereas school focus on context-independent modes of thought. For many schools, a child, is context-free. A school views all its learners as one. They do not focus on individual differences. And this results in alienation or isolation of schools. For example, language of the tribal children is very much influenced by the socio-psycho environment of their community. When the tribal children school through dominant language, they face socio-psycho-linguistic problems due to the context of the community, because their context is altogether different from the context of the school, from the culture of the school. So they feel isolation. And sometimes this can be the reason of dropouts, of their discontinuation from the studies, for their disinterest in the studies, because they are not able to understand the language of their teacher. Children are being influenced by the community to which they belong. For example, Paniya is one of the tribes of the tribal communities in Gudulur, Tamil Nadu. They are socialized in their tribal language, so their kids know their native language well. But when they were exposed to the spoken and written forms of Tamil in schools, having different grammatical structures, they can't achieve. They become underachievers, and this led to psycho-socio-linguistic drift. because they can't comprehend the Tamil. They are well versed in their native language. From this example, we can conclude that the setback to school achievement is attributed to the diglossic nature of Tamil language. Most of indigenous children turn away from school because they do not speak and use the official language, which is used as a medium of language in the school. As we know that school is being surrounded by an unfamiliar language without help to learn, which means that children do not pick up national language or state language and find learning very difficult. They are well versed in their native language, but the school language or state language or national language is entirely different from their home language. So, they found learning very difficult. Then there are a lot of pedagogical imbalances between the needs and interest of the learner and the curriculum and the transaction modalities of the school. So, many children quickly lose interest and leave the school, resulting to high dropout rates. So, language becomes an important factor in school attrition rate. According to NCF 2005, in a country like India, most children arrive in schools with a multilingual competence and begin to drop out of the school system because, in addition to several other reasons, the language of the schools fails to relate to the language of their homes and neighborhoods. Most children leave school with dismal levels of language proficiency in reading comprehension and writing skills, even in their native languages. So, as NCF has rightly said, that language, we live in a multilingual country. In this country, language can be used as a resource, but our schools are not able to capitalize on this. Language becomes a reason for high attrition rate of the learners, because children are not able to cope up with the language of the school. They are not able to communicate with the school, so resulting in the isolation. There are a lot of instances, research studies, which shows that it is vital to begin education in language children know the best, that is their mother tongue. So, all instruction should be in the mother tongue. Due to imposition of English language in India, it becomes a reason why many children are not able to achieve according to their potentials, because English is imposed upon us, our learners. And strategies for bridging home language and school language in the context of globalization, in an age of technological advancement, a child need to learn many languages. And that a suitable strategy should be need to evolve for the process of transition from the home language to the school languages. A child can learn many languages, but beginning should be made in the language he or she known, that is the mother tongue. All primary education should be given in the mother tongue of learners. Gradually, with proper help and strategies, they can learn many languages. They can learn English also. Active participation of parents, peers, and children is needed. Teachers should encourage students to use their dialect material in the school curriculum, and due considerations should be given while textbooks are prepared. Child native language or child dialect should be given respect. Teachers must respect linguistic and cultural diversity of the country and should use them as a resource. And it should emphasize the need for mother tongue education, which was the need of our teaching in mother tongue, is not a burden, it is a necessity. Teachers can teach best and student can learn when they are, when the whole teaching learning process occur in their mother tongue. The students in the rural area feel alienated as their home language is different from school language. And the only strategy to overcome this problem is to impart education in the home language of the child. Home language is related to children's achievement. Research has shown that children whose home language is same as that of medium of instruction in schools have higher achievement rate than children whose home language is different from medium of instruction in their schools. Rather than imparting education in incomprehensible standard languages, we should look for alternative strategies to overcome language disparity. Educationally, appropriate approach should be provided to teach in mother tongue with built-in mechanism for acquisition of communicative and academic skills in the school language for its use as a medium in the later stage of education. This would require drastic change in the mindset of the teachers who are practitioners. Many a time teachers ridicule if a child speaks in his or her dialect. But teachers should understand that language is a resource and they should respect the home language of the learners. Then there is a community language learning. CLL is an approach in which students work together to develop what aspects of language they would like to learn. The teacher acts as a counselor and a paraphraser, while the learner acts as a collaborator. Although sometimes this role can be changed. Sometimes a learner can teach his native language to the teacher. Barriers in community language learning. When learning a different language while in a multilingual community, there can be certain barriers that one definitely will encounter. The reason for these barriers is that in language learning, while in a multicultural community, native and non-native groups will think, act and write in different ways based on their own cultural norms. So this becomes a barrier. Research shows that students in multicultural environment communities communicates less than that are familiar with their culture. Nurturing language development. In the end, we can say that parents, caregivers and teachers need to nurture the language development of the learner through certain strategies. Teacher can help sustain natural language development by providing environments full of language development opportunities. Understand, teachers should understand that every child's language or dialect is worthy of respect as a valid system for communication. It reflects the identities, values, and experience of the child, family, and the community. Teachers should encourage interaction among children. Peer learning is an important part of language development, especially in mixed age group. Activities involve a wide range of material should promote talk. There should be a balance between individual activities and those that nurture collaboration and discussion, such as drama, role play, block building, and book sharing. Every area of the curriculum is enhanced through language so that the language classroom full of active learners are hardly ever silent. Medium of instruction at primary level of education should be mother tongue of learners, as learners learn best in their mother tongue. Benefits of teaching in mother tongue. In the end, we will discuss about the benefits of teaching in mother tongue. Home language or mother tongue, the language of the home, larger kinship group, street and neighborhood that a child acquires naturally from his home or societal environment. To quote Shri S. N. Chattopadhyay, beside being the most potential means of communication, mother tongue is the most effective means of transmission of culture. Mother tongue is endowed with the eloquent virtues of speed, clarity, spread and comprehension. So, this is again echoed by Nelson Mandela. If you talk to a man in a language he understands, that goes to his head. If you talk to him in his own language, that goes to his heart. Very well said. As mother tongue touches the heart, so it is the most effective tool to communicate. Thank you.